There was no mention of Jammu, that train from Delhi to Jammu. And that the track that you are building now to Srinagar, the time has come that you should consider that track also for a high-speed train.
Okay.
Madam, we'll definitely do that. And I want to tell you, when the Mufti Mohammad Sahib was here, he told me that you are connected to Delhi. So we said that we will connect to Delhi and we will connect to Delhi. So we will definitely talk about this.
Question number 244, Sri Harish Meena Ji. Harish Meena is not there. Dr. Thokchum Menia.
अध्यक्ष जी उत्तर सदन के पटल पर उपस्थापित है
सप्लीमेंट्री
आई टेक द प्रिविलेज टू थैंक द मिनिस्टर फॉर हैविंग गिवन ए एलाबोरेट एंड एग्जॉस्टिव रिप्लाई गिवन टू पेज रिप्लाई गोइंग थ्रू दैट ड्रेंसम वायरस अटैक इज एब्सोल्युटली क्रूशियल नाउ एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम मे बी बिकॉज ऑफ दिस द आंसर वॉज वेरी इलाबोरेट मैडम माई सप्लीमेंट्री इज In spite of the government's prompt action, a few days back, it has been reported that there was a cyber ransom virus attack on BSNL and MTNL. If this report is correct, it is again a matter of great concern for all of us for the simple reason that many of our official and personal communications and networks are based on them. Cyber attacks are increasingly a big threat to our vital information and communication. I would like to know from the Honourable Minister, through you, Madam, whether we are setting up a highly effective and specialized cyber agency to secure and protect our crucial services, networks, data, and installations. If so, please enlighten the August House.
Madam, I am grateful for the kind words he has used as far as the elaborate answer is concerned. Yes, the government is very cognizant of taking proactive measures as far as challenge of cyber security is concerned. We have a certain whereby we do emergency response. But just to improve the institutional architecture, we are also establishing financial sector certain, power sector certain, so that main infrastructure remains safe and secure. We are doing drilling part. Honorable Speaker, Madam, 15 mock drills have been done. 54 security auditing have been done. We are appointing about 1.14 lakh a special auditor for that purposes. And we are regularly in touch with the RBI, with the banking system, with the financial sector, power sector, that there is a coordinated response to it. We are very proud of the spread of Digital India programs and other ecosystem of India. More than about 110 crore plus mobile phones, 50 crore smartphones, 116 crore Aadhaar card, biggest startup movement, Stand Up India, Skill India, Smart Cities. India is becoming a digital power, but simultaneously, we are taking proactive measures to secure the cyberspace also. In that sense, surely we will take measures. As regard your specific query of BSNL is concerned, this is the two-day-old incident. It has been brought to our notice. CERN is taking adequate measures, and if certain lacuna is found, we will surely address them.
I will second.
Thank you, Madam. My next supplementary is how far the Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, CRET India, which provides technical support and remediation, and Cyber Swasthya Kendra, which works as bonnet cleaning and malware analysis, converge together to mitigate the threat posed by ransomware attacks. Thank you, Madam.
Madam, these are very unique innovations of our IT sector. The Cyber Swachhta Kendra, which you talked about, is available online. If any one system is suffering malware, you can access there and you can state it will be cleaned. Our CERN is also very responsive. And as I said earlier in the first part of the query, answer to the query, that we are also diversifying CERN programs. Madam, I would like to announce to this Honorable House that data is the new system of information. Data is the oil, but data protection is equally important. And data is the new oil. And therefore, Honorable Speaker, Madam, under the direction of the Prime Minister, a view was taken that we must have a data protection law. And therefore, we have set up a high-powered committee chaired by a very distinguished former Supreme Court Judge Sri Krishna, to come with a suggestion as to what further measures we need to take to ensure data protection.
Thank you, Speaker, ma'am, for allowing me to ask the question. Honorable Minister, I would like to ask the Honorable Minister, he just mentioned the government is very proactive. I want to know what proactive steps the government has taken for information computer technology, and has the government thought about all data routed through NICSI, National Internet Exchange of India? As he just mentioned in his answer, we are going through Digital India.
Yeah.
I admire him for that and admire the government for that.
Yeah.
But what steps are we doing to protect consumer data all root
just
servers are based abroad? Is the government considering AI, artificial intelligence,
yes,
and to safeguard our Indian citizens on protecting data, and what proactive steps is the government doing?
Only, that's all. Yes.
Sir, Madam, the distinguished member, who is a very promising member of parliament, I must flag that, has asked a question, but if he would carefully go to the D and E part of my reply, I have taken particular care to inform this Honorable House as to all the elaborate measures which we are taking, about 19 in number, they have been quoted in extension.
Yes.
If the Honorable Member has certain more suggestion to give, I'll surely welcome that. But yes, you are right. India is becoming a digital power. Therefore, we are elaborating our own system. I would like to convey to this Honorable House, Madam, that as far as Aadhaar is concerned, the entire system is in India, safe and secure. Similarly, we have to make conscious effort to emphasize upon the larger need. We have come with digital locker program where millions and millions of documents are being kept. So we are undertaking that. It is a part of the process. But one thing I would like to flag in this Honorable House, that even if the data processing center is outside India, those who are operating on that platform need to understand there is a proper law of India, the IT Act, and they need to follow that.
Dinesh Trivedi.
Madam, I also would like to compliment the capable Honorable Minister for an elaborate answer. Madam, having said that, the modern warfare is not going to be fought with bullet or bombs, is going to be cyber attack.
Yeah.
And I'm sure the minister and the house is aware that the world has no clue about prevention, because this attack can come from anywhere, and we have seen it. In your answer, you also mentioned about WannaCry. The world has seen it. And we are very proud that India is going to get digitalized and is going to lead the world. And I just will complete my question in a minute. And I have no doubt the answer is also going to come from India, because we have the best talent within the country and outside the country. Madam, having said that, yes, you can clap on that. Having said that, internal security is looked after by Ministry of Home Affairs. External security is looked after by Defense Ministry. Cyber attack is both internal and external. And Madam, it's very, very specialized area. Would the government consider having a separate ministry altogether, which could be known as Ministry for Cyber Security? Because in coming days, this is going to be as dangerous as a nuclear warfare. Thank you.
Speaker, Madam, Honorable Dinesh Trivedi ji is a very senior member, and I quite share his concern, except to flag this issue that our Prime Minister himself publicly stated that cyber war is akin to a bloodless war. And not only in India, but also abroad, he has been articulating this concern. And he has impressed upon the need for greater synergy between all the countries of the world. Therefore, we are working on that direction.
Yes.
But one assurance, Honorable Trivedi ji, I would like to share with you, that even though these digital fugitives, if I can call them, they are seeking to attack installations world over, the attack on India has been minimum, because we have been taking proactive measures. Yet we have to be on guard. Regarding the creation of a separate ministry is concerned, That is a suggestion. But as far as our government is concerned, there is proper coordination between the Ministry of Internal Security, between the External Intelligence, between my ministry and the IT, where CERT-IN comes in, and the Home Ministry, and also military capabilities. Therefore, there is a proper synergy as far as a concerted attempt towards cyber challenges is concerned. If you have certain more concrete suggestions to improve the system, you are most welcome.
Yes, Sharad Tripathi, short question, please. बहुत समय हो
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद अध्यक्ष महोदया मैं विशेष रूप से अपने माननीय मंत्री जी को बधाई दूंगा कि उन्होंने बड़े विस्तार से जो एक एक बिंदुओं को हम सबके समक्ष यहाँ रखा है मैं उसी क्रम में आदरणीय अध्यक्ष महोदया मैं आपके माध्यम से मैं बधाई देना चाहूँगा डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन जी को भी जो अभी हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जी ने विश्व में एक कीर्तिमान स्थापित करवाने का कार्य किया है इसरो के द्वारा जो 114 सैटेलाइट लॉन्च किया गया आज हम विश्व में एक नंबर पर आ गए उसी क्रम में अध्यक्ष महोदया मैं माननीय मंत्री जी से जानना चाहूँगा कि उस सैटेलाइट के माध्यम से हर एक संस्थानों के निगरानी के लिए उस पर कार्य करने के लिए विस्तार से ऐप बनाया गया है तो क्या माननीय मंत्री जी इसरो ने अभी जो लेटेस्ट सैटेलाइट लॉन्च किया है उससे संबंधित कोई नया ऐप साइबर सुरक्षा के लिए प्रयोग करने वाले हैं
माननीय अध्यक्ष जी जो सम्मानित सदस्य ने शुभकामना दी है मुझे इसके लिए धन्यवाद और मामित्वर हर्षवर्धन जी को एक बात मैं उनको विनम्रता से बताना चाहूंगा कि साइबर चुनौती जो है देश में तो सरकार के सभी अंग उसमें समन्वय से काम करते हैं क्योंकि ये सिर्फ एक विभाग का काम नहीं है साइबर की चुनौती कृषि में भी आ सकती है सेटेलाइट में भी आ सकती है आईटी में भी आ सकती है सेना में भी आ सकती है तो इसलिए समन्वित काम तो इसका एक सबसे महत्वपूर्ण लक्ष्य है लेकिन जहां तक आपने बात की ऐप की तो अब ऐप CERT-IN एक तकनीकी विषय पर विचार करके किस क्षेत्र के लिए क्या बनाना है ये चुनौतियों के अनुसार विचार करता है उसके बारे में टेक्नोलॉजी में सक्षम लोगों के भी विवेक पर भी हमें छोड़ना चाहिए एक बात मैं अवश्य आपको बताना चाहूंगा कि समय समय पर निर्देश देना ट्रेनिंग देना ड्रिलिंग करना जुडिशियल ट्रेनिंग पुलिस ट्रेनिंग अभी मेरी तरफ से विभाग की तरफ से सारे बैंकों को निर्देश दिया गया है कि आप अपने यहाँ साइबर सिक्योरिटी ऑडिटर रखें तो ये सारा एक सतत काम है इस काम को हम करते रहेंगे देश के अंदर मुझे सबसे इस बात की प्रसन्नता है और मुझे सदन को बताते हुए संतोष हो रहा है कि सारे प्रदेश सरकार केंद्र सरकार और सभी संस्थान सुरक्षा साइबर चुनौतियों को एक स्वर में ले रहे हैं और एक साथ काम कर रहे हैं
क्वेश्चन नंबर 245 स्वागत राज जी
मैडम क्वेश्चन नंबर 245
यस मिनिस्टर
स्टेटमेंट इज लेड ऑन द फ्लोर ऑफ द हाउस
मैडम आई एम थैंकफुल टू द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर
दोनों विस्तार से बोलने वाले हूँ मैं शॉर्ट बोलने के लिए रिक्वेस्ट कर रही
हूँ बहुत शॉर्ट आई एम थैंकफुल टू द मिनिस्टर ही हैज गिवन अ डिटेल्ड रिप्लाई टू द स्टडीज बीइंग डन इन द वेस्टर्न अरेबियन सी विथ रिगार्ड टू बायोजियो केमिकल चेंजेस इट इज ट्रू that this biogeological changes, these are very important for the lives of fish and nutrients which go from the land. They feed the phytoplanktons, which in turn feed the fish. Now, I'd like to know from the Honorable Minister that the government has imposed a ban on trawling during the monsoon. I would like to know from him what effect this monsoon ban on fishing trawlers has had on the improvement on the biogeochemical things of the sea, whether his researchers have done any study of that.
Sir, as I have mentioned in the answer itself, that right now, starting from 2010, 24 detailed studies have been done, and they have been done at most prestigious institutions of the country, some of which I have mentioned in the answer also. And these studies have actually been undertaken at different places. We had observation centers in Goa, in Kochi, and in the Arabian Sea, and they have been from very reputed scientists. And as I have mentioned, that the impact of in the studies the harmful impact of the human intervention at the coast. It has not been established or it has not been seen right now. Regarding your specific question that you just now mentioned, that what is being imposed during the monsoons, the studies have definitely shown a positive effect in this context, that much I can assure you.
Thank you, Minister. My second supplementary is that mainly this evolution of phytoplanktons and other nutrients for the fish, they depend on a thing called upwelling, which is the rise in the level of the sea. Now the minister has said that the human interventions have had no impact on this, excepting in around the city of Mumbai. Now the Supreme Court has already initiated the coastal regulation zone. That is, they have prohibited any construction within 500 meters of the sea coast. And there is also the problem of climate change and global warming on the rising level of the sea. May I ask the Honorable Minister whether he is considering any change in the coastal regulation zone requirements so that this spoiling of the sea's natural situation is prevented by human intervention.
Madam, through you, I wish to convey to the member, I appreciate his question and his concern also. I would like to tell him that, you see, fortunately, at the moment, I am in charge of the Environment Ministry also and the Earth Sciences Ministry also. And all these concerns about the coastal zone regulations, they have all been spelt out by the Supreme Court also. We have, you know that the latest what has happened on this front is the report of a committee which was appointed by the government, which is called the Shailesh Naik Committee, who was a former secretary of the Ministry of Earth Sciences. In our ministry, in fact, in collaboration with what the Earth Sciences Ministry says and what the environment people feel, we are studying the detailed aspects of all this, including this report, what is happening in the whole world. And we are, in fact, now at the moment working on a coastal mission plan, which will in fact take care of all the totality of the issue in its, you can say, with all its comprehensiveness. And very soon, in the next few months, the government will come out with this coastal mission plan, which will take care of all these factors in its totality.
Vinayak Rao, short question, please.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, समुद्र के ऊपर बायो जो केमिकल और केमिकल चेंजेस बड़ी गति से हो रहा है और उसका सीधा दुष्परिणाम मत्स्य बीज के ऊपर तो हो रहा है, लेकिन साथ साथ समुद्र तटीय जो बस्ती है और अन्य किसान है, खेती है, उसके ऊपर ही हो रहा है। और उसके ऊपर अध्ययन करने के लिए सरकार ने कई राज्यों में विश्वविद्यालय का निर्माण किया है। मेरा प्रश्न एक है अध्यक्ष महोदय, जैसे कि वेस्टर्न अरेबियन सी के तटीय में 5 राज्य आते हैं, उसमें महाराष्ट्र सबसे बड़ा है, जिसके पास 725 किलोमीटर के समुद्र है। और मैं इस समुद्र में पालघर, ठाणा, रायगढ़, रत्नागिरी के कई जिलों में से केमिकल पोल्यूशन बड़ी मात्रा से समुद्र में हो रहा है। मेरा विनंती है माननीय अध्यक्ष महोदय आपके माध्यम से मंत्री जी से कि महाराष्ट्र के पश्चिम अरेबियन सी में होने वाला ये दुष्परिणाम को रोकने के लिए महाराष्ट्र के 5 जिले में से रत्नागिरी या ठाणा में विश्वविद्यालय का निर्माण करें और उसको होने वाला प्रदूषण को रोकने के लिए क्या उपाय योजना करें।
अध्यक्ष महोदय, मैं माननीय सदस्य को बताना चाहता हूं कि ये जो विषय है, इसके बारे में खाली एक पर्टिकुलर स्टेट से जुड़ा हुआ कोई एक विश्वविद्यालय नहीं, लगभग देश के नेशनल लेवल के भी और इसके अलावा जो है स्टेट्स के अंदर भी जो रिलेटेड यूनिवर्सिटीज हैं। जैसा मैंने कहा कि अगर मैं आपको लिस्ट पढ़ के सुनाऊंगा तो देश के सभी प्रतिष्ठित संस्थान जो साइंस के भी हैं, एकेडमिक भी हैं और जो इस सब्जेक्ट से रिलेटेड हैं, वो इस विषय के ऊपर बहुत गंभीरता से अध्ययन कर रहे हैं। और जैसा कि मैंने अपने आंसर में लिखा है कि
जो इसके संदर्भ में जो नुकसान है वो उस प्रकार का अभी तक इन सारी स्टडीज़ के अंदर नहीं पाया गया है, जो फिजिकल प्रोसेसेस हैं, बायोलॉजिकल प्रोसेसेस हैं, केमिकल प्रोसेसेस हैं, जियोलॉजिकल प्रोसेसेस हैं, इन सब के कारण जो है, क्योंकि जो इसका जो थोड़ा बहुत इफेक्ट भी होता है वो 1 किलोमीटर के अंदर अंदर होता है, और जो समुद्र का कोस्टल जोन माना जाता है वो काफ़ी आगे तक माना जाता है, थोड़ा सा बम्बई के अंदर बाकी जगह के मुकाबले थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा होता है। जहाँ तक आपने किसी पर्टिकुलर विश्वविद्यालय के संदर्भ में बात की है तो आई विल फाइंड आउट एंड सी कि अगर ऐसी कोई सुझाव देने योग्य चीज़ है तो हम संबंधित जो हमारा सरकार का मंत्रालय है उसको वो सुझाव जरूर देंगे।
डॉक्टर शशि थरूर, शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन, नाउ टाइम इज अप।
वेरी शॉर्ट मैम, आई ऑल्सो रिप्रेजेंट अ कोस्टल कम्युनिटी ऑन द वेस्ट कोस्ट।
दैट्स व्हाई
आई जस्ट वांट टू स्ट्रेस, the government has, as you know, imposed a 61-day trawling ban to preserve fish stocks, and Kerala state government has added another 47 days. I am wondering whether your studies of the issues that Professor Roy has raised can also study the impact of this trawling ban on the fish stocks, because right now they're hurting the livelihoods of our fisher folk down the west coast of India. They're not able to live properly, they're not getting government assistance. If this ban is not actually achieving its intended purpose, let us allow our fishermen to live, because right now, madam, we have a genuine problem for the fishing community.
You see, I think already Professor Saugat Rai had asked this particular issue, and I had flagged that the studies till now have certainly shown a positive effect. As far as the concern for the fishermen is there, you see, the government of India as well as all the state governments, I am sure they are all equally concerned about their welfare. In the government of India itself, we are using science to deliver the best possible informations to fishermen using the latest technological tools to ensure that what is best for them, how they can pursue their profession, what are the safest zones for fishing for them, where they can get their maximum fishes. And also, as far as the government is concerned, I can assure you that we are equally concerned about their welfare. If it was in their benefit, the government would not have imposed that ban. And if you are yourself saying that after the ban imposed by the central government, the state government has followed it up with further number of days, so definitely this is supported by scientific evidence and facts.
Thank you. Question hour is over. Honorable members, I have received notices of adjournment motion from some members on different issues. So I have therefore disallowed all the notices of adjournment motion. Papers to be laid on the table. Sri Sadananda Gowda ji.
Madam Speaker, I beg to lay on the table of the House the papers mentioned against my name at serial number 2 in today's revised list of business.
Sri item number 3, Rao Indrajit Singh ji.
Speaker, Madam, I rise to lay on the table of the House papers mentioned against my name at serial number 3 in today's revised list of business.
Item number 4, Rajiv Pratap Rudi ji.
They will make the note. महोदय, आज की सूची में क्रम संख्या 4 पर संशोधित कार्य सूची में दिए गए विवरण को मैं सभा पटल पर रखता
हूँ। आइटम नंबर 5, नरेंद्र तोमर जी, धर्मेंद्र।
माननीय अध्यक्ष महोदय, आपकी अनुमति से मेरे सहयोगी श्री धर्मेंद्र प्रधान जी के नाम के आगे क्रमांक 5 पर उल्लिखित दस्तावेज सभा पटल पर रखता हूँ।
आइटम नंबर 6, जितेंद्र सिंह जी।
अध्यक्ष महोदय, आपकी अनुमति से मैं आज की संशोधित कार्यवली की क्रम संख्या 6 पर मेरे नाम के आगे सूचीबद्ध कागजात सभा पटल पर रख।
आइटम नंबर 7, मनोज सिन्हा जी।
अध्यक्ष महोदय, मैं आपकी अनुमति से आज की संशोधित कार्य सूची की क्रम संख्या 7 पर मेरे नाम के समक्ष उल्लिखित दस्तावेजों को सभा पटल पर रखता हूँ।
आइटम नंबर 8, पीपी चौधरी जी। यस पीपी चौधरी।
Madam, I beg to lay on the table of the House the paper mentioned at serial number 8 against my name in today's revised list of business.
Item number 9, Secretary General.
Madam, I have to report two messages from Rajya Sabha regarding Constitution 123rd Amendment Bill 2017 and the Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Amendment Bill 2017.
The reports of committee, Sri Shanta Kumar ji.
महोदय, आज की कार्यसूची में मेरे नाम के सम्मुख क्रम संख्या 10 पर यथा सूचीबद्ध सरकारी उपक्रमों संबंधी समिति का 19वां प्रतिवेदन प्रस्तुत करता हूँ।
टेम नंबर 11, पी करुणा करण जी।
द 9th रिपोर्ट हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश वर्जन्स ऑफ द कमिटी ऑन एब्सेंस ऑफ मेंबर्स फ्रॉम द सिटिंग ऑफ द हाउस हैज लिस्टेड अगेंस्ट माय नेम at serial number 11 in today's order paper.
Number 12, Veerappa Moili ji.
Madam Speaker, I would like to present a copy of the 49th report, Hindi and English versions of the Standing Committee on Finance, as listed against my name at serial number 12 in today's order paper.
Number 13, Rakesh Singh ji.
मैं क्रम संख्या 13 पर मेरे नाम के सामने सूचीबद्ध कोयला और इस्पात संबंधी स्थायी समिति के हिंदी और अंग्रेजी संस्करण सभा पटल पर रखता हूं।
14 श्री जितेंद्र चौधरी।
मैडम, आई वेक टू ले दी फॉलोइंग रिपोर्ट्स हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश वर्शंस ऑफ द स्टैंडिंग कमिटी ऑन कॉमर्स एज लिस्टेड अगेंस्ट माय नेम एट सीरियल नंबर 14 इन टुडेस ऑर्डर ऑफ पेपर।
स्टेटमेंट बाय मिनिस्टर श्री राजन गोहिन जी।
Madam, I rise to make a statement on the status of implementation of the recommendation and contained in the 13th report of the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Railways, 16 Lok Sabha. The 13th report of the Committee on Demand for Grants, 2017-18 of the Ministry of Railways, presented to the Lok Sabha on 10th March 2017, contained 14 recommendations and action taken notes thereon were furnished to the Committee on 5th. June 2017 in English and on 8 June 2017 in Hindi. A statement showing details of all the recommendations contained in the report and implementation status thereof is enclosed. Since the statement is voluminous, I request that the same may be taken as it.
17, Sri Aluwalia ji.
Mahodaya, main aapki anumati se apne sahyogi saathi YS Chaudhary ji ka vaktavya सभा पटल पर रखता हूँ।
हाँ बोलो।
मैडम स्पीकर, मैं आपका ज्यादा समय नहीं लेना चाहता हूँ, तो खास करके मैं एक एडजर्नमेंट मोशन दिया था तो उसको तो आपने रिजेक्ट किया, लेकिन उसकी मकसद यही थी, द पॉलिटिकल वेंडेटा unleashed by the government of India using central investigation agencies against the opposition party leaders, particularly in Karnataka, for their political gain points to a dangerous tendency in the country which would ruin the very ethos of democracy, demands a clarification. Mera kehna yahi hai ki डेमोक्रेसी में अब जब चुनाव चल रहे हैं गुजरात में और खास करके राज्यसभा के वहां पर 3 सीट के लिए चुनाव हो रहा है और कांग्रेस के पास 57 मेंबर्स थे और उसको और 4 मेंबर्स का सपोर्ट था, तो उसके बाद तोड़फोड़ करके 5 मेंबर्स को उन्होंने अपने पास लिया। नहीं नहीं, मैं बैकग्राउंड बता रहा हूँ, तो ये इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट को यूज करके ये कर्नाटक में जो ईगल रिसोर्ट में एमएलए थे, 42 एमएलए, उन एमएलए के डरा के धमका के टेररोइज करके वहां पर ईडी के लोगों को वहां पर भेजा है और उन पर
करके भेजा है।
यस, भेजा है, भेज के आज वहाँ पर या वहाँ पर आज जो मेंबर्स थे 42 मेंबर्स, उनको डराया धमकाया जा रहा है इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर्स के तरफ से, और उनको डरा के पहले तो गुजरात में हुआ, उसके बाद में सेफर प्लेस समझकर वो दूसरे तरफ मुंह हो गए, लेकिन वहां पर फिर इन्होंने इनकम टैक्स के लोगों को वहां पर भेजकर वहां के सिर्फ उन्हीं के ऊपर नहीं, वहां के कांग्रेस नेता के ऊपर भी रेड करके जिस रूम में वो थे उस रूम को भी उन्होंने सर्च किया। अब इसीलिए मैं ये चाहता हूं कि अगर इस ढंग से वेंडेटा विच हंटिंग अगर इस देश में चला तो कोई पार्टी डेमोक्रेसी में बच नहीं सकती। ठीक है, किसी कोई अगर इकोनॉमिकल ऑफेंस किया है, कोई व्यक्ति, कोई लीडर, कोई भी होने दो, अगर मैं भी अगर किया हूं तो आप कानूनन मेरे ऊपर एक्शन लीजिए, लेकिन आप पॉलिटिकली एक इलेक्शन जीतने के लिए, एक राज्यसभा का उम्मीदवार को हराने के लिए आप ये जो कोशिश कर रहे हैं, इसमें कामयाब नहीं बनेंगे, इसमें कामयाब नहीं बनेंगे। मैं कह रहा हूँ कल के दिन यही मुसीबत आपको झेलना पड़ेगा अगर कोई लोग इसी ढंग से करे तो। इसीलिए मैं चाहता हूँ आपके ओर से कि मिनिस्टर इसको क्लैरिफाई करिए, क्योंकि वो कहना भी चाहते हैं, मुझे मालूम है कि एमएलएस के ऊपर मैं नहीं करना चाहता हूँ। वहाँ पर कोई मिनिस्टर थे, एमएलए थे, उनके ऊपर हम कर रहे थे, लेकिन ये ठीक नहीं है। इसीलिए मैं उनसे अपील करता हूँ कि ऐसा टेररिज मत करो, डराओ मत, धमकाओ मत, इससे डेमोक्रेसी में काम चलने वाला नहीं।
मैडम,